What is an idea? An idea is that one person takes at least two formerly known things and combines them in a new way. One person takes two formerly known things, combines them in a new way. For example, like this. We take the concept of, take the concept of a ship, which is a previously known thing. We take a concept of a parachute, which is a previously known thing. Now we have ship and we have parachute. Now we combine them, what do we get? Ship, parachute, combine, what do we get? Parasail, good. Ship, parachute, combine, what do we get? Give me another one.
Hovercraft.
Huh? Hovercraft. Hovercraft, yes, why not? I must tell you this, I've done this in Norway two times, and both times they have said, you take boat, you take parachute, you combine it, James Bond. Which I think, when you hear it, it makes total sense. You take a boat, you take a parachute, you combine it, you have a parachute on a boat. And this is a German, I think this is a German invention. It's called Skysail, and it works basically as a giant kite board. It is said to reduce oil consumption by up to 20%. It's a brilliant, green, environmental, cheap technology if it will work as it's planned, but the person who invented it just took two previously known things and combined them in a new way. And why I like this definition so much is because it shows it's impossible to invent something out of nothing. The head of R&D at AkzoNobel said, I am not looking for people who give the correct answer. I'm not looking for people with knowledge. There are literally millions of people, young people, in India and China, graduating with knowledge. The price of knowledge is going down. The value of knowledge is not... The value of knowledge is going down. Doesn't mean knowledge becomes irrelevant. It means it becomes less valuable. 100 years ago, it was a competitive edge if you could read and write. Today, it's not a competitive edge, it's a demand. That means the value of being able to read and write has gone down. Doesn't mean it's useless, it means it's less valuable. When my parents went to university, it was a competitive edge to have gone to university, because only 5% in Sweden went to university. Today, more than 50% go to university. It doesn't mean the value has disappeared. It means it's not a competitive edge to go to university. It's a demand, it's a prerequisite. He said, I'm not looking for people with knowledge. I'm not looking for people with information. I'm looking for people with imagination. And he said, the problem with that is, that's much more difficult to find. There's only one way to figure out how to use all these new ideas and innovations that we are inventing right now, and that's not knowledge. That's creativity and imagination.